I'm going to cover the top 5 features in the Power BI October 2018 update, and number 1 would change your life. At the end of this video, you can also access the complete playlist with highlights for all the recent Power BI updates. Hey, I'm Avi Singh, Power BI Pro, and I help companies and individuals get quick and powerful results using the Agile method for Power BI. Now, if you want to become a Power BI Pro, make sure to hit subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. We're going to cover the 5 key highlights from the October 2018 update. Now, number 5 is one of those hidden gems which you may not be using often, but really should. But let's start with the life-altering number 1. Now, if there are any updates or changes that you are looking for in Power BI, make sure to post them in the comments below so we can all vote for them on the ideas site. So the number 1 mind-blowing, life-altering feature in the October update is data profiling in the query editor. Let's take a look. Data profiling can prove invaluable when you're connecting to new data sources which you may not know everything about, which kind of happens all the time when you're starting to build a Power BI model. So here I'm going to connect to a SQL Server data set, and again I'm going to pretend I don't know it. Well, it's adventure work, so I do, but let's say this is a brand new data set and I have no idea about it. So here I'm going to start with the AdventureWorks data warehouse, and again, this is pretty common scenario with warehouses. You're going to see a long list of tables. Now, my number one advice would be that pick a data table. It may be called a fact table in a warehouse. So we're going to pick fact internet sales, and I'm going to click this button to select the related tables. Now I'm going to select the related tables and I'm going to click edit so I can show you data profiling in the query editor. Now, data profiling, you're going to see it in these bars right below the column headers. So that's the first starting point, but I'm going to show you there's a lot more underneath there. So when you click on a table, you might see it kind of going through and kind of doing the profiling for you, but then it'll light up. Now, green is generally good, but you can see more details by going on the view menu, and here you would click on column quality. So now if I look at column quality, notice that for this one, everything is green, values are valid, there are no errors, and there's nothing that's empty. Now, if you look at, let's say, dim product, you can see that there are no errors, but some of these values are empty in a lot of places. And of course, if you work with AdventureWorks, you know that category is oddly, category subcategory is empty for a lot of products. So that's kind of an error. That's something you might want to look at, dig deeper into, talk to whoever owns the data source. And of course, if there are errors, in case you're trying to convert it to a number, but not all values are numeric, then these would show up here. So this is a great starting point, but that's just the first step. Now you can go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the column quality, and I'm going to turn on the other data profiling feature, which is column distribution. And boy, I mean, if you would ask me which one is more valuable, it'd be hard to pick. And I'll show you exactly why. So column distribution, first of all, you can see that product key, you can see that there are 606 distinct value, and each one of them is unique. So they're not repeated at all, as opposed to product alternate key, which has 504 distinct values, but some of them are repeated. So for this one, it can be a good validation for, this column is a key column which you can use to establish relationship. Now, of course, AdventureWorks is simple, it's named key, but often in real life scenarios, you don't really know. You don't really know that, is this column unique or not? And the data profiling can now tell you that. Another place where this can be helpful is just trying to understand which are the more important columns. Now, if you generally look at lookup tables, kind of like product, you know, the who, what, where, when, how that I talk about. So it's customer, territory, if you're thinking finance, kind of the account hierarchy and so forth. And generally, which are the more important columns? I look for columns which have like, you know, 3 to 5 values, because usually they represent these high level categories that everybody wants to look at data starting out. And then, of course, there is a drill down beneath that. So that's a pretty classic scenario in lookup tables. You're looking for some kind of a hierarchy. So what you could start with is look at values which have just a kind of a few numbers. And as you will see here, once this stops spinning, which is right now, category is a great one to start with. So I would use this to, as a starting point, and I would then actually look at the category and then try to find the next level in there. And again, AdventureWorks is easy, but believe me, knowing something like this can be invaluable in you trying to understand exactly what the hierarchy is and understanding the column, the structure of the data. So that's everything that Data Profile can teach you right now. But my friends, more is coming soon. In fact, if you do have feature requests that you've submitted, ideas, post them in the comments below so we can all vote for them as well. But yeah, keep an eye out for more in this area. Let's talk about number two, controlling the data export options in your report. And this can be critical. Let's take a look. So I'm going to show you where you can change the data export options. You would go to File, Options and Setting, Options. And once that pops up, you would go all the way to the bottom to report settings. Now, if you see over here, this is the default export option. And earlier, we didn't have any control over it. The only thing that was allowed was users were allowed to export both summarized and underlying data from the service. And I'll show you exactly what each of them means. But now we have these options to only allow export of summarized data, or just stop that export and not allow it. Now, this is a file level option. I'll also talk about a global option. So let's go. Now, of course, these ones apply to the PowerBI.com service. If you hand somebody the Power BI desktop and it's got all the data imported, they already have access to the data anyway. So again, this applies to the PowerBI.com service. So let's go there and take a look. So I have uploaded three different versions of the same file just by changing those settings for each one. For this first file, this one is default, and you can see here that if I go in here and say export data, I can choose summarized or underlying data. And underlying data would give me more detail. Just to give you a look, this is what the data would look like. So the summarized data would essentially give you the data which is in the visual. So in the visual, I have sales and budget by category and sales and budget by category. Well, there's a drill down there, so the subcategory is shown here as well. And detailed data will show you the underlying data. And as you can see, this has product name, product key level data, which is nowhere to be found in the visual, right? So it gives you a lot more detail. And again, so you can understand that sometimes you would want to report users to have summarized data, but not be able to dig into the data. Now, this can happen in the scenarios even within your company where you're sharing these reports with everybody and just don't want them mucking around in the detailed data. Or certainly if you're a consultant and or providing a service to other users where you want them to be able to look at the reports, but not have access to the underlying data. So let's see how this differs. So the first one, you saw the default, it lets you export either one. Now this one is no export. So notice here that the export is grayed out. There's no way they can click on that. And the third option, of course, is if you only enable summarized data, if the user clicks export, the underlying data option is grayed out and cannot be selected, but they still have access to summarized data. So now you have this ability to choose this setting on a file level basis. Now what I would say is admins, of course, have an ability to go to the admin portal and turn this off entirely. Now, of course, this is a hammer, so use it carefully. And of course, you have a little bit more control. You can enable it on security groups. So you have all the control at a global level and also at a file level now. Let's talk about number three, fuzzy matching when you're merging queries. Let's take a look. Now, all of the files that I show in the videos, you can always download them by going to learnpowerbi.com/download. So what we have here is a category table, which has categories listed out, accessories, bikes, clothing, component, and some description there. Now we have our data coming in where the category is not an exact match. Now, query editor, you have to remember, is case sensitive. So this is not an exact match, and cloth and bike isn't either. And if you look at the merge right now, it is merging based on the category, but it is an exact match. And we can see the results that it doesn't quite match this one or this one. You can see it's returning null for the description. So now let's take a look at the fuzzy matching. We're going to go back to the queries dialog box, and here we have the checkbox that we can check, use fuzzy matching. Now there are more options here that you can set, including threshold, which goes from 0 to 1, ignore cases, spaces, and so forth, right? But I'm just gonna, you know, ignore those for now. Just turn on fuzzy matching, hit OK, and now let's look at the results. So great. So now you can see that this one where the case was different and this one where it was bike versus bikes, they both were able to match. So again, try to use fuzzy matching where it works. And it does have one option that I wanted to highlight was you can build your own transformation table. So if you have your own specific transformation, like, oh, MSFT is Microsoft, like, which, you know, the fuzzy logic would never quite pick up, but you can supply that as your own list as well. So a pretty cool feature. Number four is really simple but really useful, search in filter cards. So we have had search in slicers for quite a while now. So you can see this is a slicer and it allows me to do a search, but now we also have search on the filter card. So there's a search box. So if you have a long list of things and you're trying to find them, it's gonna make it a little bit easier for you. Number five is the hidden gem that I talked about. So let's take a look. This is about explaining, well, let me just show you. So this is one of the features that I don't use often, but I really should, and maybe you're in the same space. Now this feature has existed in Power BI, which is you can just right click on many elements in the graph and just say explain the increase. And Power BI digs through your data and finds out those nuggets of insight that, hey, this is what's causing you the biggest impact and increase in whatever metric you're looking at, sales or something else. And it gives you a lot of, and as you scroll down, you can see different kind of insights that it has pulled through, and it gives you that starting point for looking for that needle in the haystack, that what is causing that change? Why is this happening? And you have lots of options in here. You can choose different visualizations. So really useful feature, but the key change with this update is that now it works for additive as well as non-additive measures. So here I have a sales, which is a simple sum and additive measure, but you can have a distinct count, which I have a product sold, or an average purchasing price, and you can still right click on it, and in this case it's going to explain the decrease and find out for me the key insights contributing to the decrease. So those were the October highlights. Now, my friend, if you have a feature or change you would like to see in Power BI, make sure to leave that in the comment below so we can all vote for that. And you can click here or down below in the description to access the complete playlist to get caught up on everything that has happened with Power BI monthly updates. And if all of this leaves you feeling overwhelmed, then I would remind you to focus on the 20% of the core concepts that give you 80% of the results. And my Power BI tutorial is a great place to start with that. Until next time, power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.